basic idea of the Libertarian Party. But I'll add one more piece to that. The Libertarian Party understands that law is very powerful. Law is very powerful because at the end of every law is a person with a gun who will put you in a cage. And if you don't want to go in that cage, that person will shoot you. That means that you only use law when there's something that really matters. Loss of life, loss of property, loss of health, threat of loss of life. That's when you begin to use law, when there is a victim. But you don't use law unless there's a victim. Did you want to do that also?
Yeah, I would do that.
Oh, please go ahead, yes.
他这个说的呢，就是自由人虽然尊重每个人的意思，但是这个法律是最重要的。当然这个法律可以作为一个武器，就是逼着一个人非要把你关起来，这就是个法律。当然正因为法律的使用有这么大的这个影响的时候，所以只有在必须的时候影响到你生命了，或者威胁影响到你生命的时候，这个法律才应该被使用，这是他们的法律。
So that's what we believe. So we're trying to make New York a better place. I'm running for a very important reason. Look at right now the past 16 years.In the past 16 years, the Republican Party in this state has not won a statewide election. It has not won governor, lieutenant governor, AG, senator, nothing in 16 years. So the Democrats have run this state for 16 years. If they were going to fix this state, they would have. Now the Republicans have been watching this for 16 years. Now where is their plan? Where is their movement? Nowhere. Nowhere. They're doing nothing. Over 100,000 New Yorkers leave this state every single year.
How much?
Over 100,000 New Yorkers leave this state every year. That's a lot. As they keep leaving, our tax bill keeps going up, but the people keep going down, so we have to pay more taxes.As we pay more, it becomes harder and harder for us to survive in this state. Please.
就是从2002年开始，这个纽约州整个的，不管是州长、副州长，这个司法总长，所有的都是在这个民主党的这个控制之中。如果纽约州有任何问题的话，这都应该归咎于民主党。民主党应该已经把这个事情给改过了，但是没有。那共和党做了什么？共和党就站在一边看着，什么事情也没有做。共和党没有改变任何事情，所以说他们要出来。而且有一个问题，目前纽约几乎每年是有10万人以上是流出纽约的，就是说他们觉得纽约税太高了，个人自由太少了，怎么样？他们就说，所以他们要站出来，自由人党就是要改变这个。
So I'm running for a selfish reason in a way. I don't want to move.I don't want to be one of those 100,000 people who leaves every year. I don't want to be that person. I want to stay in this state. I love this state. It's an amazing state. People love New York. They just hate the government. So I want to fix the government so that people will want to stay in New York. So, you want to do that?
Yeah, 所以他就是他自己不想搬离纽约，所以他就想改变这个东西。就是说，虽然我是自私的，我想搬下来，我想留在这里，我不想搬出去。所以那怎么办呢？我就要投身政治，我要改变这个。
So let me tell you a little bit about me. I was born in Manhattan, in St. Vincent's Hospital. They tore the hospital down. I was adopted. My birth parents gave me up for adoption. I was adopted and I was brought to the South Bronx. That's where I was raised as a young child, right by Yankee Stadium.I was there until I was about 11 years old. So, I was there until I was about 11 years old. My mother was a waitress and a banker. She was an immigrant. My father was a corrections officer at Rikers Island. Neither of my parents were educated. My mother didn't even have a high school diploma.
我是出生在这个曼哈顿的，是叫史蒂文森医院，后来已经被拆掉了。他的收养父母是住在这个 Bronx 南区，他住在那地方有11年。他这个父亲呢是做这个监狱的管理，就是狱警。然后他母亲是做一个这个服务生，但是他们俩都没有受到什么教育，母亲连这个高中学历都没有。
So my parents worked hard. We had part-time jobs. This is the 1970s, and my parents were DJs in the disco era. It's true, yes. and they worked part-time jobs and made enough money so we could move out of the Bronx, and we moved to Suffolk County. We lived out in Suffolk County in Long Island. That's where I went to high school. It's actually where I met my wife, believe it or not. I'll tell you that story in a second. So that's where we met. When my father moved out there with us, when I was 12 years old, he died. He died of cancer, and when he died, it was very hard for me. Very hard, so of course, at 17, I decided I wanted to leave, so I left and I joined the Marine Corps.
然后，七十年代的时候，他父母是在那个做DJ的，所以他们也很用功，挣了一个钱，就搬离那个Bronx，去了这个沙普斯康特。然后在那里，他上了高中，遇见了他以后的这个妻子。但是很不幸的是，他刚去到那里的时候，他父亲比他十二岁的时候，因为癌症去世了。对于这一点，他也很悲伤。所以17岁的时候，他就离开了参军了。他是参加了海军陆战队。So
I went off and I joined the Marines. I was in the Marine Corps for almost 7 years. And the funny thing is, I joined the Marine Corps for a very important reason, which I didn't know then. And that is, I was searching for positive male role models, which I did not have in my life. And the Marine Corps gave me many of them. So it saved my life. The military is not for everybody, but it definitely was for me. When I came back from the Marine Corps, my mom was in a very tough place. She was addicted first to legal drugs, and then eventually illegal drugs. My mother could not handle me leaving, and she could not handle my father dying. And she was a convicted felon. She was in prison, and I pulled her out of prison.
很不幸的就是，他自己呢，当然是他觉得他参军对他是非常有价值。他在那里这个遇见了他这个找到了他真正需要的像道德上的典范模范。他在参军是7年的时间，1986年在93年。不过很不幸的是，当他回来之后呢，当他回到家里之后呢，发现这个他父亲已经早就去世了，妈妈也是这个成瘾了，就是毒品上的成长。
When my father died, his side of the family abandoned us and walked away from us. My mother was an immigrant, so she had no family here either. And I'm an only child, so it was only me. So I decided to help her, of course. I used my savings to get her an apartment, I used my savings to get her a car, to get her started. Try to get back in her life. And if you've ever had a felon in your life, you know it's hard. It's difficult to get a job after being a felon. It's hard to do that. And I saw my mother struggle, and I hated it. But we still got up and running. She got a couple jobs. But the hardest part was, when she was an employee, she was a hostage to her boss, because she was afraid that if she lost her job, there was no other job for her. And I hated my mom being a hostage.
其实有一个很重要的原因，就是他母亲其实是一个移民，是一个幸运的。当他父亲去世以后，他12岁就去世以后，他父亲那一方的这个亲戚其实又不再管他们了。所以你想，他母亲他又是一个独生子，然后他母亲又没有别的亲戚，所以很可怜一个状态。但是他回来之后呢，他就努力的让帮助他妈妈回到一个正常的生活。因为他被判刑入狱之后，他妈被判刑入狱之后，在美国是很难再找到工作的，所以请求他们给他帮助。所以他就。
So I decided to do something about it. I didn't like my mother being a hostage. I hated it. So I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start a business. So we became truckers. We bought some trucks. We became truckers. When we started the business, it was me, my mother, and my stepfather. My mother had gotten remarried. And I had no ownership in the company. You know who owned the company? My mother did. I made sure my mother owned the company, because if my mother owns the company, she's the boss, she can't be fired. And if she can't be fired, she's not a hostage. So we started that business and we ran it for a couple of years.
Okay. 所以他们就什么办法呢？就是他们就创立了一个公司，这个是他母亲，然后他继父，就他母亲就结婚了，就是这个我们也有党员愿意做一个 trucker， 就是买一些这个卡车啦，就是做这个生意。然后他把这个公司的这个所有权交给他母亲，这样的话他母亲就不用再担心被别人给开除掉，再也不用担心像以前工作时那样的状态。
So after a couple of years, the business was going well. I left. It wasn't my business. I left. My mother and my stepfather ran that business until they retired. And when they retired, the harsh part is when they retired, they left New York State. Like so many people did, they went to South Carolina. And because it was so much cheaper and so much better, so she took her retirement and left. And my mother actually passed away in South Carolina. And it was bad because I had a child at that point. And so my daughter lost her grandma. which was not good. Again, New York State being so oppressive, it actually tears families apart.
这个公司经营得很好呢，然后他就离开了，就交给他妈妈在做，他妈妈和他继父后来也经营这个公司直到退休，但是退休之后他们不在纽约待着，因为纽约这个税太高了，所以他们搬到南卡，在南卡的地方税率比较低，在南卡他母亲也去世，那个时候他刚有了这个他的女儿，所以这也是很不幸的事情，他女儿虽然没多久就辞掉了他的这个祖母，他把这个原因归咎于说这是纽约的政治导致他们一家人这么苦。
So, second?
Yes, close to much.
Yes, yes. So, excuse me, that's not to me. Okay. So I went off and I had several jobs and then I started another business on my own. That business did not do well. I sold that business off. Then I started another business which I have now. And right now I'm a teacher, a trainer, a consultant, an executive coach. I've been doing this for 14 years.I have some large clients like Models and Estee Lauder, and some smaller clients like small law firms and IT firms. I've taught in several colleges, John Jay College, Baruch College, and I've taught at the graduate level as a guest instructor at both Yale and Columbia.
后来我也又开了一个这个私人的这个公司，但是这个没有做得太好，就卖掉了。现在呢，就是他是一个做这个经理人，然后做这个顾问，然后做这个教练，然后他也现在也在这个一些知名的学校，像 Yale 啊、Columbia 啊，就做一些教一些书，然后在 Baroque 学院也是教一些研究生的课程。
So, but I haven't done that for over a year because I've been doing this. Something to remember: when I'm in front of you, I'm not in front of clients or customers.I don't get a salary. I'm my own person. So when I'm here, I'm not getting paid. Literally, last year doing this, I lost over 50% of my income. This year, I will lose over 75% of my income. I have a wife and two kids, and I live here in New York. My wife does not work. You can imagine what my bills are. But I don't want you to feel sorry for me. I knew what I was doing when I jumped into this. What I want you to realize is I'm serious.I wouldn't sacrifice like this if I wasn't serious.
Okay, 但是呢，他这个刚才讲的那些，他做教练的事情，他只做一年多，他就不干了，他就相当于说现在全职的来竞选了。去年他至少在公司丢失了一半人，然后今年积的这个应该是少于75%，少75%。而且他现在有两个小孩，他妻子也不工作，你可想而知这经济负担是多大。但是他对这个。你们大家不要为他悲伤，他是非常认真的来投入做这样的事情，他就是希望你看到。
So I'm doing this because I don't want to move, because I want to stay here in this state. The other two parties have done nothing, and let me give you, if I could, their plan. Here is His Majesty King Andrew Cuomo's plan for us, to help New York. Finished. That's the plan. Yes. His campaign is one thing. His whole campaign, one thing. I hate Trump. Finished. Nothing else. That's his whole plan. Right? Now the Republican. Let me give you his plan for New York. Finished. His entire campaign is, I hate Cuomo. That's the whole campaign. That helps nobody.
但是他为什么还要积极这么来投入这个竞选？因为他有一个方案，如何来改变纽约。但是另外两个大政党是什么样子的？一个是已经世袭统治了多少年的那个纽约州州长库姆，没有任何东西，就是说我反对川普，就是反对美国总统就好了。然后共和党是怎么做呢？就说我反对库姆，就完了，就是他们没有提出任何的正当理由要做什么，而只是说把他们竞选主流放在说，我反对谁，我反对谁，没有说我做什么。
So I'm trying to change things. I'm the guy who has gone around to all 62 counties in New York State, all of them. I've been to every part of the state. Not just that, I'm the guy who gives you actual answers to problems and questions. I have ways of fixing education, ways of fixing small businesses, ways of changing taxation. I have ideas that people are thinking about. Now some of you might say, I like your idea, but it isn't as good because of this problem or that problem. Here's the issue.You can't judge my idea against perfection. There is no perfection. And if you judge it against perfection, I always lose. I'm not perfect. Instead, judge my idea against status quo. What's happening now? Is my idea better than that? Yes, because I have one. So by default, mine are better. But what does that mean? It also means I know I could be wrong. Which means if you want to help me to make my ideas better. I will still put this state in the right direction.
纽约州有62个县，每个县我都跑遍了，在这个竞选过程中。然后呢，和其他人不一样的就是，我有一个具体的这个竞选方案，无论是教育问题、税收问题、小企业问题等等。当然，有些人也说了啊，你们政党中有这个问题那个问题，但是我的这个回答就是说，人当然不是完美的，不可能。我说我的，你要说我的答案一定是一个完美的，那对不起，我肯定是输的，做不到。但是有一个重要的是，我这个答案是不是比现行的这个更好？是不是有更能改变这个现行的这个制度？这现行的体制当然是。当然，如果我有任何的其他的那些缺陷的干嘛，你能提出意见的，我非常乐意听取这意见来帮助我做更好。
So I could talk here for another hour or two or three, but I won't. What I'll do instead is I'll open this up.For more questions, so that you can tell me what you think is important. And here are my rules on this. None. You can ask me any question about anything. You can make any comment, and I'll deal with any comment. I will make sure one thing. I will answer every single question. The only issue is, there are many times you'll notice, I don't have any notes. I just speak from the heart. Next, I will never pander to you ever, ever.I will tell you what I think is honestly true every single time. I also know that nobody in this room will agree with me 100%. I know that, and I'm okay with that. All I'm asking you is, do you agree with me 80% of the time or more? 80% for two reasons. Number one, when I was in the Marine Corps, my first commander-in-chief was Ronald Reagan. And Ronald Reagan said, if someone agrees with you 80% of the time, they are your ally, not your enemy. So if you agree 80%, you're my ally.And not just that, I'm a business guy. You guys who are business, you know. The 80-20 rule, 80% is a big, big deal in business. I'm looking for 80%.
Okay, 我接下来可能就不再多说了，而是回答大家愿意提出的任何问题。你们也看到了我前面没有这个 note, 没有做这个笔记的这个事先准备好一些什么答案。然后你们提出了任何问题，我也会毫不犹豫地回答。我知道不会再做这个所有人100%的同意我，但是我只要80%我就满足了。因为我在做有两个原因，我在做海军陆战的时候，我第一任总司令是里根总统。里根说，如果有一个乙方80%同意你，那这肯定是你的盟友，不要再犹豫了。当然，这个商业中大家也知道有一个叫80-20原则，就是说你80%的利润来自20%的利润，如果80%就已经非常好了。OK, 就这样。
Good, please, any questions?
OK, 我们接下来那就进入提问环节好了。这个现在也很快，是6:23，反正我们大概到7点钟，然后还有30分钟，好吧？
哦，
陈
教授 ，I'm sorry，OK,
we have source test, 还有别的那个麦克风吗？
有，
让
有，
谢谢，
谢谢。
Yeah, maybe I'm the only journalist here, sir. And you mentioned that you sacrifice a lot of income.
Sure.
So what type of expectation, in general role as governor of New York, what type of income normally is? I mean, I will ask the questions make more attractive to Chinese, you know, people.
So you're asking me what expectations I have?
No expectation, I mean, what's the salary level as a governor?
$179,000 per year.
I see. So, okay, the next question, relevant. In China, you know, most officials, they run for officials or they get the position, they give a lot of money, bribery.
Sure.
After they got the position, they receive a lot of bribery.
Sure.
You listen to the news, a number of officials, they found cash.
Yes.
In tons, billions, at least 100 millions.So what's your comment?
Yes, no, it's a great question. And yes, it's a great question. And the issue of corruption in New York State is huge. If you know in New York State right now, there are, I think if I'm not mistaken, 8 different people who have either gone to prison or will be going to prison because of corruption in the last, I think it's a couple of years that's happened. So it's a big problem in New York State. Corruption's huge, yes. What am I going to do about it?Several things I'm going to do about it. Number one, remember something. I don't have a bunch of people that I have to pay back. I'm not part of the establishment, right? The establishment now, they have people they have to pay back. Both the Republican and Democrat, they are literally career politicians. They have been in politics since they were 18 years old. I've been doing this 1 year. You want to do that first? Then I'm on.
刚才韦斯提问的第一个问题就是说他对纽约州长这个薪水的回去，他说就17万美金就好了。然后第二个问题是他会说，你看中国官员是那么腐败的选举，你里面的价没收这个上亿元的这个成吨计的现金，问他对这个腐败有什么看法？他就说，是的，这个纽约市的腐败，确实纽约州的腐败，在美国而言，全美国都是非常严重的。过去一年至少有或者有8个人，要么是即将，要么是已经是因为这个腐败问题而入狱。但是他不一样，因为这个不管他和这个共和党和民主党一样，他不是一个职业的一个政客，他没有说一大批这个人啊，你是我的人怎么样？我要那你把我选上来之后，我要给你很好的东西，没有这个，他是一个自己，他就是去年开始才投入的投这个东西。
So they raise millions of dollars, right? Millions. I've raised almost 500,000, and my average donation is about $85. $85. Who am I paying back? There's no one to pay back. I don't have big people to pay back. I also don't have a career to protect, nor do I have friends to pay back. So that doesn't exist for me.
你像他们这个在竞选的时候，两党都是说百万的那种竞选这个资金，然后我这个到现在为止是50万 50万，平均每个人就是说这个给他这个小额这个竞选支持的时候，也就$85一个人，谁花了$85来支持我，又会预期我要给他什么样的好处？没有，所以我不用说我上来之后去 pay back 那些人。而且我也没有说这个，这也不是我的职业，我也没有朋友专门要这个什么给他们一些好处，所以我在我这方面也没有这些来源。
Next, I'm a business person, which means I know a very simple formula that always works. Personal freedom plus transparency plus accountability equals innovation, which means I have to have accountability and transparency.If you have accountability and transparency, you will have less corruption by default. That's just how it works. When people are becoming or trying to do something corrupt, they don't think in their heads, I wonder if I'll get 5 years or 10 years. They don't think that. They think, will I get caught? If you have an environment of transparency, an environment of accountability, there'll be less corruption.
而且呢，我自己是个商人出身的，我知道的就是说，在商业中，你要想那些好主意创新，你就需要3个条件：第一，它有一个一定程度的个人自由；第二，它有一个透明的个人权利；第三，这个他对他的项目要负责。类似的，在公共领域中，在这个政治中，如果能有这个透明和这个负责任的，让他就只有他的责任的话，那我们就不用担心这个贪腐的问题。因为你要知道，那些人腐败的时候，他心里并不是想着我做这个事情是判我5年呢，还是判我10年，还是判多少？他心里就想着我会被抓到。他如果我们这个环境是能轻松的让他这个很公开透明的地方，他做什么事情会被抓到，他自然就不会。
Now, when it comes to transparency, I will literally have a department of transparency. Literally. Which means 2 things will happen. When something goes wrong, you will simply call the department and they will shine a light on it. If you want bad behavior to stop, the number one thing you must do is shine a light on that bad behavior. Number one, this isn't the only thing, but it's the most important thing. You shine a light.People will begin to stop. Right now, if you try to find out what happens, you don't. You don't. No one tells you, you get stopped. But my Department of Transparency will literally make sure that everything gets shown, and it will create an environment to where whistleblowers are not enemies of the state, but whistleblowers are heroes. It will change everything.
Yeah. Yeah. 我首先要成立一个部门，这个部门的名字就叫透明部，他们的这个有2个方面，第一呢，首先就是要曝光，那这个如果有任何问题发生的时候呢，你要把它曝光出来，让别人知道他这个做错了，这样的话呢，那些人犯错误的机会就减少了。但目前的情况就是说，当你发现觉得什么问题不对，你就跑到部门去问怎么发生的，几乎很难得到什么答案。然后第二个就是 除了这个，我还要鼓励那些敢于就是 whistleblower， 就是你这个把这个举报出来，敢于举报的，让这些举报这些人让他们意识到，他们这么做是对这个社会有好处，他们是英雄，而不是什么恶行。
But even that's not enough. And you asked a very serious question, and there are many things that have to fix this because we have a culture of corruption. The second part of that, or the third part of that is, we have a series of boards or committees or authorities that are all around New York State. If you see all those people who are arrested and indicted and convicted, they're all on a board of this or a committee of that or an authority of this. What does that mean? Right now, the current structure is the governor appoints people to all of these boards. These people have given him money, exactly what you said. They've given him money. He's raised over $800,000 from people who he's put on boards. So he puts them on a board. They then become corrupt. He says, as the governor, I don't know what they did. So he doesn't go to jail. They go to jail. We have to end the idea of boards, committees, authorities, because these are not, they're in no way, shape, or form accountable to anyone. They're just appointees accountable only to the governor. Instead, we want to make any type of board or committee local people who are accountable to the local people. That will also change. Elected, yes. Campbell, yes.
还有一个问题，就是说不仅仅是这个机构，还有一个就是在纽约有一个比较贪腐的文化，就是说这个州长啊，他有权利任命在这个各个地方的，你比方说这个什么叫 board 啦，什么叫 committee 啦，什么委员会的之类的，州长直接任命他就好了。任命就像这个有一个人，就是说他花了$800,000这个支持这个州长，然后州长呢任命他为一个 board 里面去了，然后他在这个他的这个委员会里面，他有因为他有说了算的权利啊。他自己就搞这些贪腐的事情，过目就只是说，哦，那这个人反正只是我任命，我不知道他是怎么回事。但是这样是不够的，怎么样改变呢？就是说，对于这些委员会，虽然我们目前不能废除，但是我们要改变它的产生办法，不能只是说州长任命他，而是说要当地的，因为他如果对当地事务有决定权，那就当地的人直接选他就好了，直接这样的话就公开了。
I'm sure you've seen it to where you go to a board and you petition and you say I care about this issue or I care about that issue, and they're very polite, they smile and nod.And do nothing. And change nothing. Because they don't really care about you. They're not accountable to you. They're accountable only to the governor. That's how that works. That has to change. And you know it's a bad culture. And I say that because when Cuomo loses this election and I win, there will be a power vacuum. And when that power vacuum comes, everyone will think there will be a bloodbath. There will not be a bloodbath. I want to work with people. I want to fix this state.There won't be a bloodbath. And when they see that, the environment will change. And they'll realize that if they are corrupt, they'll be punished. They'll understand that. Right now, if you see, when they go to court, many of the people going to court, they actually say, yes, I did it. They say, yes, I did it. But they're going to court. Why? Because they believe it's the only way to get things done. They think everybody does it.You can't be mad at me because everybody does it. So I'm innocent because everybody does it. With these three or four things, we can change the culture and corruption will not be ended. No one can end corruption, but we will lessen it and find it a whole lot faster.
就像刚才我讲了他讲的那个什么暴力之后，很多人会到这个委员会前去说啊，我有这个问题，这个问题，那应该就是说笑笑而已，但他不改变，不解决任何问题。那么，我们必须要改变，必须要产生，因为他们只对州长负责，这是不可以，就是说要改变他们产生办法。然后，当假如说我这个不是假如，他很有自信，他这个竞选会能成功之后呢，他会把之前这些人开除掉。但是之后，但那不是叫权力真空，那会同样的会有很多人来加入这个事情，他愿意和这些人继续合作，能把他改变过来。当然呢，就是说这个不会，你像那些现在的那些贪腐的那些官员，他们说他们在上法庭的时候，他们会很坦然说 ，OK， 这些事情是我是做了，因为大家都这个样子，每个人都贪，那么我也没有办法也会做事情，所以说我是希望呢，就是说我刚才提的那几个办法，包括这个选，包括透明部啦，包括鼓励这个举报啦，然后这个设立这个改变这些机构产生的办法了，希望这些能够。虽然不会完全彻底的消灭这个纽约州的贪腐，但是会极大的减少。这样的话，我们又为下一步来做好准备。
Did I answer your question?
Maybe you can add a few comments. What do you think? I know every country has certain, you know, corruption, but the degree, you know, magnitude is still totally different. In China, you know, it's a poor country, but tons of cash at home. So what's your comments about China? What, you know?
Oh, you want me to comment on China?
Yeah.
Sure, okay. There has to be a cultural change in China also.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same issue, right?
Yeah.
There has to be a cultural change.
Yeah.
You can't.
Corruption or culture?
Yes, you want to have a culture. You want to change the culture, right?
Yes, corruption.
That's correct. Because again, if the reason why you find this so common is because people think it's the way to get things done.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, and this is just a fact, if you look at any story of someone who becomes corrupt, most people who become corrupt aren't actually bad people. Most don't start that way. They become bad because the culture shows them it's the only way to get things done. Some people are bad and they're corrupt immediately, absolutely. But most aren't. And you see this when you change the culture, you get less corruption.
I think by culture, what you mean is the
environment, you mean?
The environment.
Ah, yes. Maybe I mean the environment. Maybe it's a different word.
The government's environment.
Yes, I mean the environment that the government survives in, right? The environment would be an environmental change, right? The change that the government is in. Because the average person who goes in is not corrupt. The average isn't. Again, to be clear, there are some bad people who are corrupt, of course. But the average person isn't. They come in, they want to get things done, they get told, just give me some money. We'll do it. You want to help him? I want to help him. You want to help him? Give me some money, and we'll help him. And that's the first step. Then step two, step four, it's too late. You're corrupt. And that's how most people go into it. You change the environment to when I said, come on, give me some money. Or you say that, and I say, no. Let's just help him. No money. Let's just help him. When that becomes the environment, the way we do business, things begin to change. So we have to have an environmental or a...
I agree with the culture word.
Culture is better?
Yeah.
Yeah, we want to have a change to the government culture. Yes.
对他刚才这个韦石就追问了，就是说那针对着中国的这个腐败环境他有什么评论，就是他也说那中国也需要改变这个文化，就是中国现在目前也有腐败的文化，就是说不管是中国还是美国，其实绝大多数贪腐的人，有一些人是很坏了，他拿到这个那个职位他立刻就贪腐，但是绝大多数人他在进去的时候他并没有想到说我立刻我就要把那个职位拿过来搞钱怎么回事，而是他进去之后他发现说啊，你不交钱不给这些钱你把这个事情做不成，你只有给了钱他才会给你做这个事情的话，那么他受这个你称之为文化也好环境也好或者政府文化也好这其实是一个词了，就是说你不改变这样的话呢，单单抓几个人也其实是不足以改变这个腐败的，我觉得这个理解是对的，没有问题。
OK, can I answer your question now? Great, excellent. Are there any other questions or comments?
Next.
Yeah, how about the women rights of the boards and the gun rights?
Sure.
What's your thing?
Yes, I'll touch both of them.
他问的是女权和这个关于枪的问题。两个问题嘛。还有生育权，女权妇女权利生育权利问题。But not gun rights.
Gun rights, yeah.
OK, 也包括那个枪支的权利。
So, two different questions.
Yeah, two different questions.
Yes, and the first one, do you mean abortion rights?
Yes.
Ah, OK, thank
rights.
You. Sure, absolutely, yes, no worries. So, here's where I am. I'm the oddball here. I'm the weird guy here. I am someone who says the government has no right deciding what a woman should do with her body. At the same time, I personally am anti-abortion. So, I don't want you getting an abortion. And I will tell every woman that. I don't want you to, but I will not use government to stop you. Right? I want, again, to change culture. I would like it to be easier for a woman to have other options. In New York State, we don't have that. What does that mean? It's personal for me. I was adopted. Right? My mother, my birth mother gave me up. My birth mother could have aborted me. She didn't. So of course I'm anti-abortion. Of course I am. But then it was easier for me to get adopted. New York State must change its rules. It should be very easy to adopt and very easy to have surrogacy. We don't have that right now. And if you're a woman who's pregnant, most women, or too many women think, my only option is abortion. And it isn't. There are other options available if New York State would make it easier.
Okay.
right? For example, if you were pregnant and you, and you didn't want to have your baby, there are many people in this state, I mean thousands of people, who would happily pay all your medical bills, pay for everything to have your baby. Thousands of people would do it. We could do it, but we can't in New York State.
Okay.
If adoption was easier, you give your baby to adoption easier. People would actually adopt your baby. We could do that. So, I do not want you to have abortions. I don't. At the same time, I will not use government to force it. I won't do it. I will make it to where there are less abortions by women choosing to have less abortions.
Yeah, it's important. Yeah. 他的个人立场、和他个人经验有关系。他母亲一生下来就放弃他了，他是被收养的。所以说从他个人的，他很有可能当时就被这个堕胎掉了。所以从他个人的体验上，他自己是反对堕胎的。但是他认为政府绝对是没有权利来干预女性是否有权利堕胎的，这两个是有区别的。所以他希望做到的是什么呢？就是能目前让纽约州政府能鼓励更多的让这个女性有其他的方案可选，不是说啊你除了堕胎把她生下来自己养就没有别的办法了。但是目前纽约州呢，你如果想这个收养别的那个小孩是非常困难，所以他是主张就是说，我会告诉别人你们不要去堕胎，但是呢，目前的法律环境不太适合，所以他希望改变这样的目前纽约州这样的规定，让这个收养会更容易，而且收养代孕，就是那个这个代生那个，就是希望把这项法律这个放宽，让这个别人有更多的，尤其妇女有更多的权利，就是这个样子。
Did I answer that question?
Yeah, this is complicated question. So,
say again?
Very complicated. So that's the issue. So I know, but I agreed some.
Did I answer the first part?
Yeah.
Okay, so the second part is gun rights.
Yeah, gun rights.
Okay, good, gun rights. All right, I am the only gubernatorial candidate, the only one who is a supporter of the Second Amendment.
Okay.
I absolutely support the Second Amendment. I do. Mm-hmm. I think you have a right to bear arms.
Yes.
I absolutely believe that to be true. Yes.
Yeah.
So I'm against the SAFE Act. The SAFE Act should go away. What the SAFE Act actually did, because most people don't understand this, the SAFE Act actually made millions of New Yorkers criminals overnight. Millions of people who purchased their firearm completely legally overnight became violent felons, according to New York State law, because they had a piece of plastic on their firearm that someone deemed was evil or bad.It literally made millions of New Yorkers criminals overnight. Second, it makes our medical community part of a secret state police. Literally a secret state police that reports on people. They report on people. So you have a car accident, and a person comes into the emergency room, and they say, how do you feel? Oh, I feel terrible. I want to die. They write suicidal. It's true. They write suicidal.And then the state police come and take that person's firearms. And if that person resists, they're either going to jail, they're going to a hospital because they're going to be shot, or they're going to be killed, they're going to the morgue. But here's the worst part. It affects our veterans more than non-veterans. And I'm a veteran, and that bothers me personally. Because veterans are more apt to have problems like PTSD and TBI, and more apt to have firearms. And we're a community. So we tell each other this. We say, if you get help,you're gonna get reported, they're gonna take your firearms, so we don't get help. That happens all across New York State. Now you have problems with veterans saying, here, to another veteran, take my firearms right now, I can't have them. What did he just tell his friend? He just told his friend, I put a pistol in my mouth last night and I didn't pull the trigger. That's what he just said. But he still won't get help, because of the SAFE Act. But the worst part of the SAFE Act of all of it is it creates a black market.Because now people aren't reporting their weapons. People aren't reporting their firearms. And they're selling ammunition without telling people. So now the law enforcement's job is even harder. The SAFE Act makes no one safer.
Okay.
Trying to make guns illegal never works. Let me give you a quick list of all the times prohibition has worked. Finished. It doesn't work. You want to stop this? Change again the culture.That's the issue. The best defense against people hurting you is people not wanting to hurt you. That's the best defense. We change our culture, our environment, we can fix it. Did I answer your question?
Let me translate first.
Oh, yes, I
did. Let me translate first.
Let him translate. Hold on, let him translate.
Wait a minute.
He's translating.
Translate first.
Yeah,
okay. OK， 他是这样的，他是这个在纽约州呢，他是支持第二这个修正案的，就是说他是支持拥枪的，反对禁枪的，尤其是他有一个纽约州有一个法案叫 Safe， 这个 Safe 法案就是关于控枪的。他是说这个有几条理由啊不好啊，第一条呢就是说他让很多大概有这个数字可能有上百万纽约持枪的人呢，这个由于不小心啊，他就犯了一下这个就犯了重罪了。第二点呢，他这个说，因为这条法案呢，他有一个是要让医生举报报告给这个警察，关于说某个人如果有自杀倾向之类的啊。这个他举了个例子，比方说有一个人发生了个车祸，他这个说很不舒服，可能要死了，然后这个警察这个医生可能就把这个事情报告给警察说，你看他有自杀倾向，这样的话呢，警察就要过来把他的枪给没收，这样的话他导致双重伤害。第三个呢，尤其是对他们这种人不利，因为他是老兵嘛，这个精神上。这个大家都知道，他有这个战后这个创伤综合症，然后呢，老兵又爱玩枪，所以说他举了一个例子，有一个老兵就是把那个给他朋友说，我把这个枪昨天晚上就是放在我这个嘴里，但是犹豫了一晚上没敢开枪。他的这个事情他也不敢报告给，如果报告给医生的话，他的枪就被没收了，所以他要只好要把这个枪送给他的这个朋友，也很难拿掉。第四个呢，就是说因为这个法案导致说好像很多枪支变成这个原本是他们合法买的那个枪支啊变得有问题了之后，那这个枪他们就赶快想偷偷的把它处理掉卖掉，结果导致了纽约出现了一个很大的枪支的这个黑市。所以总之这几条理由使得他反对说这个纽约现行的通过这个 Safe Act 来让纽约的这个更安全。他说禁枪是解决不了这个枪支暴力的问题，什么样才是呢？就是说还是他说的，就是改变这个文化，让大家呢这个让大家就是说不再有心去伤害别人的时候呢，那么这个枪也就不会成为问题。 OK，
枪的问题
我再
问一下。
OK，
so do I answer your questions or two?
But others have this question.
Okay. It's okay, but as long as I answer, just make sure I answer. Thank you.
Yeah, maybe. 那他先问，他一会儿讲。
Connect to the gun. Sorry. Hello.
Yeah. Oh, what about these people over there? They didn't answer.
No, no. Last
question. Oh, okay.
Because I think
about his gun rights.
This is gun related. Because down the road, I mean, down the line. Because you know, from Chinese account, the people read the news say, you know, U.S. going to the gun law, right? But my understanding, you know, the U.S. almost every people have the right to own the rifle, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, the dispute is, you know, assault weapon and, you know, handguns. So you say, you know, the people need to protect themselves. I think, you know, the shotgun can protect the home, right?
So I don't know what your question is.
Yeah, my question is,In the U.S., no people say we are going to restrict the ownership of guns.
Mm-hmm.
The Second Amendment is there. The dispute is what type of weapons, you know, different states have different rules. So, I mean, why you know, promote, say, you know, the people must, you know, have freedom to own, you know, carry the handguns. So
you're asking me why I support the Second Amendment?
No.
I'm not sure what you're... I don't understand your question.
No, I mean Second Amendment, my understanding, all states allow people to own long guns,
mm-hmm.
shotguns. The difference is handguns, assault weapons. I mean, personally, I promote Second Amendment.
Sure.
I'm a
mm-hmm.
hunter, so...
Sure.
But for the people don't understand, right? Many people say, you know, why you should own assault weapons? You have a rifle already, right?
Okay, so...
What's the answer?
I see. Okay, great. Now, I think I understand what you're saying. So if I could answer that with a very important question. You're saying, why would I promote people owning assault weapons? Is that your question?
Yeah, you don't want any limitation. Right?
Ah, okay. First off, I never said I didn't want any limitation. I never said that. And also, I'm not promoting any weapons at all. I don't own a firearm. I don't own one. So I'm not promoting anything.All I'm doing is saying the Second Amendment exists, the Second Amendment is good, the Second Amendment should exist, so you should own a firearm if you want to. I don't own one. Just because I don't own a firearm doesn't mean someone else shouldn't. They should if they want to, it's your choice. That's what I'm saying. The Second Amendment is about your choice on how you defend yourself. I choose to defend myself with my wits and my words. That's my decision. Some people choose with a firearm. But your next point is assault weapon. Who decides what an assault weapon is?You? Me? Who? The manufacturer? You know what's happened with the Safe Act? Now they have Safe Act compliant weapons, right? That happens too, which means you have weapons that are just as effective, but now they go by the law. And if you know what a bump stock is, they made machine guns illegal. So they created a bump stock, which basically makes a semi-automatic weapon like an automatic weapon. That's what happens all the time. So I guess in theory, if you wanted to try to stop assault weapons, you could try it. But who decides what an assault weapon is? And then when they decide it, someone's just going to get around it anyway. So it doesn't even matter. So I just support the Second Amendment. Let the states decide.
Okay, okay. 他刚才这个韦石追问了，就是说啊，这个第二修正案确实是说民众有这个持有长枪的 rifle 的这个权利，但是关于这个手枪还有这个攻击枪支啊，这个那是否可以限制掉？他的回复呢，就是说呢，首先我是支持第二这个修正案，但是我自己其实没有枪，这个有些人是愿意用武器来保卫他，有些人他呢就选择用这个政治的话语行动来保卫自己，而且其实还有一个问题就是。哇！
能干上，能干上。
OK。那就是说谁来决定这个什么样的是叫攻击式枪支？那比方说以前的时候，那个他们的禁止这个机关枪的时候啊，他们就发明了一个叫 bump 那个东西，那个枪到那个套在那个枪支上之后，它就比那个机枪的那个效力还有效了。所以说纽约有一个叫 Safe Act 之后呢，他们有些枪支制造商就发明了一种，就是说我们符合纽约 Safe Act 的那种枪支，就是说，这个东西呢，很容易就被这些制造商了或干嘛之类的，他总有一个办法把您的规定绕过去。所以说，目前说通过这种禁止这个 assault weapon 这种方式不能解决问题。等一下 ，OK， 这个惠来有一个 ，He has another question about gun rights.
Sure, sure. Oh, gun rights matters to you guys.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Good, please.
Wait. 我问几个问题，因为我是中国民主党党员，而且我还是IDG 独立工会的会员，我也是NRA 的一项会员，我今天想问几个问题呢，就是说我们那个 IDG 呢，独立工会呢，是一个就是我是这个会员嘛，然后呢，纽约的出租车。分两种，一种出租车房车，一种是电召车，我是电召车的司机，我想问的问题呢，就是当你等到您上任了以后呢，对出租房车和电召车的有什么方案，有什么看法，这是第一，因为房车比出租车电召车呢的工资呢要高上47%，而且电召车的司机的工资呢就在低收入人群的一个这个行列里，像今年呢已经有两次在市政厅呢去抗议，去两次我都参加了，就是为了电召车司机呢提高工资的抗议活动。然后呢，我想问的问题呢，就是您对这个电召车和房车的治理方案有什么看法？第一，第二呢？您呢？
Long question.
第二呢？您对这个低收入这些电召车司机呢，您有什么方法让他们能提高上来？第三呢？您是否能站在 IDB 共独立工会和低收入司机的这个人群当中？我就这么三个问题。
OK. Although he's an NRA member, but his question is not related to gun rights. He's asking about the taxi. He's a taxi driver, but not the yellow taxi, but the car service. He wants to know he is IDG member. He wants to know your policy about the taxi driver, because many tax drivers here right now in New York actually are low income, belong to low income.
So,
do you have
taxi drivers? That was a taxi driver question.
Yeah, taxi
okay.
driver.
I like it. Okay. You mean like a medallion driver?
Like Uber.
Oh, you're like an Uber driver?
Yeah, like Uber.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Here's a general rule. As a general rule, most of that here is done locally in New York City. So I won't have that much control over that, to be fair with you, as a governor.
Okay.
The mayor has much more control over that than I do. All I have is theory that I can tell him what I believe is correct. Okay. Here's what I believe is correct. The medallion system in New York City is completely corrupt. and all it does is punish immigrants. It literally it makes immigrants become slave wages to people who bought medallions years ago, and now they have to pay, you know, horrible prices for them. It's a terrible idea. I'm not a big fan of the medallions at all. I can't stop them. It's New York City, so it's not my policy that matters, but I think they're bad. You should be able to use your property to make money to the best of your ability.
Yeah.
When I was a kid in the Bronx in the 70s, the yellow cabs wouldn't come to our neighborhood because I lived in a bad neighborhood. So what would happen is the people would actually paint one door on their car a different color. And that's how you would know. That's called a gypsy cab. Back in the day, that was called a gypsy cab. There was no Uber, that didn't exist, it was a gypsy cab. And so that guy would come around and you pay him and he'd take you around the neighborhood because there were no cabs. So I'm a big fan of anybody making money any way they feel appropriate with their own property.
OK, 他是说是这样，其实关键的问题就是说这个 taxi 的这个不属于纽约州管的，是属于纽约市管的，所以说他在这方面没有什么发言权限。但是他是认为就是说现行的采取那种制度啊，就好像把这个出租车司机当成奴隶一样的，这样让他们这是不公平的，应该让这个出租车司机有权利按照他们自己认为合适的办法来做这个工作来挣钱，简单说就是这个样子。 OK 啊、next 中景化、把这个给他吧。
Mr. Sharma, I agree with many of your opinions. I always think that freedom of movement is not only wasting one country, but also wasting the entire world. So therefore, the U.S. should remove immigration restrictions. Anyone, as long as they like the U.S. and we and are willing to come to here. So I think should let them come here. I don't know what you think about this point of view.
Sure.
Okay.
Let me think.
Chinese
modeling. Okay. 我的问题就是说呢，我首先我很赞同他的许多观点啊，然后呢，我一直认为就是说呢，这个迁徙自由啊，是呢，不单单就是是一个国家内的迁徙自由，应该在全世界范围内每个人都有迁徙自由啊，所以呢，我觉得呢，就说呢，这个美国应该废除这种移民限制啊。只要任何一个人，只要他愿意喜欢美国，愿意到这里来，就应该让他过来。所以说呢，我不知道他对这个观点是怎么看待的。Okay, thank you. Yeah.
So again, this is a tough question for me because I'm not running for president. So I don't have control over that either. The taxi one was local and this one was national. So sorry, two bad questions. So what I can tell you is I can tell you my philosophy or my ideas, but I can't really tell you a platform because I don't control that. But I do think immigration is wonderful. My mother was an immigrant. I think immigration is a good thing. I wish more and more people would be immigrants. Most of our entrepreneurs are immigrants. It's a great thing. I think immigration is awesome. I think we can do both things. I think we can intelligently both control our border and let lots of immigrants in. I think we can do both. I think it's a difficult thing, and that's why most people don't talk about it. It's much easier to say either open borders or immigrants are bad. That's easy to say, but both are wrong. The reality is we should have good borders and let lots of immigrants in, both. We should control it better.
Yeah.
And I won't do that because I'm the governor. But maybe if I run for president one day, we can talk.
OK.
Trying to send 800 military to the Mexican border, how do you think?
Say again?
Trump said Donald Trump sent 800.
Oh, the Trump government is sending the military troops to the border to stop those Honduras caravans.
Yeah, well, can you answer? Do my
yes. Okay, 他这个移民事务属于联邦政府的，那是要总统说了算，他州长选不了，管不了。但他自己有一个看法，毕竟他父母，他那个母亲是一个，也是一个移民嘛，所以说他态度应该是，当然美国应该欢迎更多的人进来，但是。 边境还是需要的，就是说还是有要把这个边境管得很好，但是应该让更多的人想办法合理的能够来进入美国，这是他的这个探讨。
Okay. Yeah, to answer your question, I'm not necessarily against it. Depends upon what their mission is. If their mission is to hurt or harm, that's a problem. If their mission is just hold the border so they can control the population, I'm okay with that. Right? I was in the military. Many things I did were not war. So it depends upon their mission.
OK， 刚才这个张军问一个问题，就是说川普现在正在已经派了800名，不知道是已经还是将要派800名士兵到南部边境线，防止那些这个洪都拉斯那些那个上千人要进入美国。他的回答就是说，那这个事情不好说，单独是好坏，要看他去那些士兵去做什么。如果那个士兵只是去 OK， 把这个边境控制好之后，让那个边检机关来更好的处理这些移民，那是没有问题的。但是如果说这个士兵去是要伤害那些人，那是肯定是他要坚持，当然是反对的。OK, next, 苏鲁叶。Yeah.
I'm going to start on another topic, because as a member of DCP, I want to know if you have any plan to support the people fight freedom for all the Chinese people in China, like what we did in America.
Okay, the DPC is Democratic Party of China.
Yes, I figured. When I knew CCP, I figured DCP. I got it.
Yeah.
I got it, yes. So what kind of assistance would you need from the governor of New York?
social media. I think social media is a good way to.
So are you asking me would I support democracy in China?
Yeah.
Is that what you're asking me?
Because that's what we did in U.S. So.
Okay, I'm unsure what you're asking me. Again, I'm governor, not president. but I can. I'm not dodging the question. I'm telling you I can't have policy, right? Because I'm not running for president. But I can tell you my feeling.
Yeah.
Of course I would support democracy in China. Of course I would. If I could help in some way by supporting them on social media or something, why wouldn't I support democracy in China? Of course I would.
Yeah. I think there is something the New York State could do.
Okay.
Because right now there is, the China government is trying to focus on the election in the state and city level, so that they could influence the U.S. politics. That's what the China government is doing. They couldn't do much about the federal politics right now.
Yeah. So you're saying like things like trying to influence people to vote a certain way. Sure, of course. Look, the reality of it is we do have to worry about our elections. We do. Yeah. They use the phrase elections being hacked. But they're not really being hacked. They're being influenced, right? So we do have to worry about that, of course. Yeah.So whatever I could do to make our elections safer, of course I would do that, right? To include things like open source, to do things that where everyone can see what's happening, where everyone could fix it, these types of things that many people have asked to do, even theoretically using some blockchain, that could even be another way of making that happen to make things safer and more transparent. So of course, yes, I would try to make that happen, of course I would. Yes.
Okay.
Did I answer your question or no?
Yeah.
Good, okay.
OK, next.
Would you want to answer that?
简单翻译，他就是说，问这个，他作为纽约州长能够怎么样支持中国的民主？他也再次声明，就是说，因为是属于联邦政府，政府他不能管理。但是呢，有一点，那个有就是说，中国政府想那个试图收买纽约市的这个纽约州的这个地方的民众，这一点的这个影响也是值得注意的。所以他是希望能通过更多的法案的，让这个在选举政治中更加透明，使得谁。花钱支持谁，投资影响谁，他都能够让大家看到，这个不至于担心这个中共的影响。OK，
Could I bring up something?
Yeah.
Can you ask how many people in this room are small business owners or entrepreneurs?
Yeah, right.
Can you ask that question?
OK， 这个他有一个问题，就是关于这个小企业的问题。这个在座的人中有谁是现在这个是创立过，或者说是参加过这个小型企业？就是说你参与过创立，不一定是你是不一定是所有者，但是这个股东也可以。我是一个。
Some okay.
想问这方面的。
想问。
Good, good, okay, good.
秀琴，你也是。对，你也是这个小企业嘛，就是你们家族企业这个东西，是餐馆也是。对 ，some of you, yeah.
I say that because one of the important policies are local that affects New York State, right? A lot of the things we talked about recently were not about New York State. This is about New York State.
Yeah.
Right. What I can do to help the small business owner, right?I can change how we do workers' comp. Workers' comp right now, you're required to have on the job and off the job insurance. I want only on the job. This will make it a whole lot cheaper for people who are trying to hire. Second, if you decide to only sell locally, you don't want to sell outside of New York State, there's already a law in Wyoming that says if you sell locally only within New York State, you are immune from all federal regulatory bodies.I can do that here in New York State for all small businesses, things like restaurants. restaurants and things of that sort that sell only locally. It will help them, mm-hmm. and also help people compete against businesses that are internet only. Mm-hmm. Because internet only will, of course, sell over across borders. They will have to follow federal regulatory bodies,
right.
when others will not. In addition, I can get rid of our insurance board. Our insurance board right now in New York State is literally predatory.
Mm-hmm.
It hunts small businesses mm-hmm. to extinction.
Mm-hmm.
We do not have to have an insurance board. Most states don't have one. We can end that. We can also get rid of all our regional economic development corporations.
Mm-hmm.
All those things do is take money from one place and give it to another, and it is a petri dish for corruption.
Mm-hmm.
That will go away also,
mm-hmm.
which means more money stays locally,
mm-hmm.
more people decide locally, and those boards were people of the community
mm-hmm.
who care about the community.
Mm-hmm.
And lastly, we will stop bribing big business to come to New York State. No more bribing big business for New York State.
Mm-hmm.
The goal is to support the small business owner so that small business becomes resilient.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you have a resilient economy.
Right.
OK， 他关于这个小企业，他有四点啊。第一点就是说，因为小企业其实要买保险的，就是比如说这个员工在这个企业的时候，他有一个保险，他离开的时候也要有一个保险。这个目前是这个，所以有两份。所以他的主张就是说，只保留一份，就是说让这个企业这个员工还在的时候，就是 on job 的那个保险。然后第二份呢，就是说，在怀俄明州目前他有一个。已经有一个法律，就是另外一个州啊，就是说，如果你这个企业卖的所有的东西、所有的服务仅仅是在纽约州内的，而不是和另外一个州没有关系的话呢，那么你就不应该受到这个联邦这个法律的这个控制。这就是说他希望通过的。然后第三个就是说，纽约州有个叫保险委员会，那保险委员会呢，目前就是说对于纽约州的这个小企业呢很不利的，他收了很多这个费用，所以他要把这个废除掉。第四个就是说，他的这个重点不是说像这个一些公司试图把这个 Amazon 之类这种大的引进来，不要再管这些大的企业给他们什么样的税收优惠，而是重点把这些放在这个小企业上，因为他们是真正的这个创造工作、提供收入这个和就业的，要让他们如何能保护小企业，这是他的这个工作重点。我觉得这挺好。Yes, very good. Okay, next. Wow, so many. The last one, the last one. Okay, yeah.
Hi, I'm Jeremy. I'm from Buffalo.
Hey, Jeremy. You came from Buffalo.
Well, I
you really do love me.
I do love you. Although you're an angel.
Thank you.
No, I actually work around here, about an hour north of here. But anyways, my question is back regarding guns. You made it clear you don't like the SAFE Act, so bravo. Number two, my other biggest concern is, what about our pistol permitting process?
Yeah.
What would you do to fix that or abolish it?
Absolutely. Look, I know that New York is a very diverse... Do you want to ask that question?
No, that's fine.
Yeah. I know that New York is a very diverse state. And in New York City people tend to not like guns. I get that. And I'm okay with that. They don't have to like guns. I'm not forcing anybody to have a gun. But if you go upstate, lots of people like guns upstate.
Right.
That's a fact. They like them upstate. That's fine. I'm happy with that too. They should be able to do what they want with it. The pistol permit should be very simple. You can have different rules by county on how you give a pistol permit. I don't have a problem with that. If you want to be more strict or less strict, I'm okay with that. To your point, I'm not encouraging anyone to buy a firearm. You can do it if you want to by your county. New York City will have more rules. I'm fine with that. But the thing is, I want New York State to change from a may to a shall issue. What does that mean? If you don't get a no, it's a yes. And right now it's not that. So the county has to have a reason for telling you no. They should also do it within 90 days. 90 days, tell you yes or tell you no.
Mm-hmm.
If they tell you no, no problem.
Mm-hmm.
As long as they give you a reason why and an appeals process.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fine.
Mm-hmm.
What will happen? New York City will still have stricter gun laws. I get it. It's fine.
Mm-hmm.
But upstate will have a whole lot easier for them upstate, and they want it.
Mm-hmm.
Does it answer your question?
It does.
Awesome.
One more question. Would you ever support constitutional carry if it came to the state?
Now it's just not realistic right now. Just isn't. The culture of New York State wouldn't accept it. It doesn't exist. Could it happen in the future? Maybe. Maybe. But just now, let's do that first.
Okay. Okay. 他的问题还是关于这个控枪的那个问题。这个他的回复是这样的，就是说纽约州其实是很多样性的，纽约市民 这个对枪支是一般来说不太感兴趣，这是没问题的。但是纽约上周那个地方，其实他们其实和大多数美国那个地方一样，他们是很爱，很多人是很爱这个枪支的。所以他的意见呢，就是说各个县，就是各个县来决定他们这个发这个枪证的这个 pistol permit 的时候，他们自己的政策来决定就好了。然后反正现在是他的希望呢，90天之内你申请的时候，他要么给一个答案，要么不给一个答案。反正是你不给的话，如果给这个答案是 no 的话，就不让你持有的话，你就上诉就好了。但是现在政策的就是他还拖着，他没有明确的这个告诉你，所以他对这个是现行反对的。然后他刚才那个人是问说，这个是应该是关于那个这个持枪之后 open carry 那个问题，那个他说这个不现实，下一步来说。OK next。
最后一个，我想问他相不相信那个 CCP 的那个Spies, working on the New York. CCP sends secret spies working on the every department in the New York. Do you require that?
I don't know that.
She's talking about the spy.
Yeah.
Sending from China.
Like the,
yeah, he's talk, she's talking about like, China send Chinese, Chinese Communist Party send a spy to every department
to
in U.S.
Like
yeah, to every level in U.S. government,
like,
do you believe that?
You mean New York State or?
Yeah, New York State.
Oh, in New York State.
他相不相信?
So the question is, do I believe that's happening?
Yeah.
Oh, I have no idea. I've never heard that until just now.
Yeah.
So maybe, I don't know. This is the first time I've heard that.
Oh, you sure search it more.
So I will.
Actually,
I will search it. I've never heard that before, so I don't know. I've never heard it. So I'm glad you told me. I will literally have my policy team look into that.
Yeah, we'll have a lot of information
yes.
for that.
So let me, thank you. Let me go back to his point. I'm always talking about New York State being more localized control.
Mm-hmm.
Always, because the counties are different.Right? Upstate New York is not downstate. Long Island is not Buffalo. They're different.
Yeah.
And I'm happy with localized control. I am. I want more communities to be more involved. 70% of New Yorkers don't vote. Let me say that again. 70% of New Yorkers don't vote because they've given up. They don't take control of their local communities because they think that Albany runs everything.
Mm-hmm.
And they're right.So we should change that, and our local community should have more power, more control. For your issue, I'll look it up. I don't know.
Okay. 来，我简单记得，待会儿是他。那个他刚才张军就是问说，他是否知道说中共在美国疯狂的派间谍，几乎每个政府部门都有。他说啊，我头一次听说这个事情，这个尤其是纽约州的。所以如果以后呢，他也很感兴趣。张军告诉他这个，他以后他会这个事情做更多了解，而且更多的重点就是说，纽约州是再重复一遍，纽约州很多地方是不一样的，长岛了、阿尔巴尼了、纽约市了，这些地方是有地方的差异性的。所以说他是希望呢，就是各个地方能对自己的这个本社区事务更多的控制。等一下，王文清。
我的问题是，非常感谢今天下午来这里宣讲自己的这种理念。我的问题是问他个人对大麻合法化和同性恋的看法。
OK, 你来翻译一下。
yeah, she's wondering what do you think about legalize marijuana and
gay marriage,
homosexual marriage.
Yeah, gay marriage.
So,
yeah, gay marriage.
Homosexual marriage and
marijuana.
Marijuana.
Okay, good. Let me do. Can I do marijuana first?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, you're laughing. I don't mind. I'll answer any question.
Okay.
I say any question. Any question. It's fine. Yes.
But it's not that way.
Number one, I'll deal with marijuana.I mix two together. I mix cannabis and hemp together because they're similar, right? So I mix them together. I think we want to regulate hemp and cannabis, particularly for farmers like onions. With one exception, you should be 18 years or older to purchase it. Why do I say that? It is a great way to help our farmers out in New York State. Right now, our farmers, particularly upstate New York, but also Long Island even, they are struggling. Many of the small farmers are struggling tremendously. What I want to do, I'm going to give them another cash crop.Now the crop they can use to actually make more money. Now here's the advantage of this. If we regulate it heavily, big regulations, like you do in California, Wyoming, I'm sorry, Washington and Colorado, big business wins, small business loses every time. And we keep a black market. So we do. This is happening right now in Washington.
That's true.
That's true. Washington, California, Colorado, there's a black market.I don't want a black market. That's when people get dangerous. That's when bad things happen.
Yeah.
I don't like that,
yeah.
Right? I want instead farmers to be able to grow when they want to grow, but here's the best part. If they grow locally, they'll sell craft products. And this becomes for investment, this becomes new business model. Right now, you look at the beer industry in New York, that's what's happening. The beer, you see it, the beer industry now is growing in upstate New York as a craft, yes, right, craft beers. Our small farmers will create craft grows. I was just in a cannabis investment summit about a month ago. I was the only person there who was invited as a governor because I'm the only one who wants to legalize. So I went there and I spoke, and there were over hundreds of millions of dollars being invested. Guess how much came to New York State? Zero. No investment in New York State. It all went outside. That should be coming to our state. Can you do that, deal with that piece first?
Okay. 关于大麻的问题，他就是说，他其实是支持合法化的，但是呢，这个目前的几个州啊，科罗拉多了、California， 它有一个很大的问题，就是说，它那个其实不利于这些小的那些种植者了，它那个管理这个政府的规章太多了，所以只利于那些大的那些企业，他们造大麻的。所以对于这个纽约，如果纽约合法的话呢，对于那也不能像其他那三个州一样啊，应该有利于这些纽约小的那些 farmer 那些居民，让他们自己种，然后自己在这地方卖。OK， 那是。
Yeah, yeah, so that's why I want to regulate it like that. So I do want it to happen. But there's something else. There are literally hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers who have chronic pain. Mm-hmm. Lots of pain. Yeah. And if you have chronic pain, yeah. you can't do what you want to do in your life. You miss your family, you yeah. miss your friends. Yeah. So you have a couple of choices right now.
Yeah.
One choice is you go to opioid. Mm-hmm. And opioids right now, the FDA approved opioid, mm-hmm. it is 80% of all our drug addicts right now mm-hmm. started...from an FDA-approved prescription drug. Mm-hmm. 80%. So if you take an opioid now, you have a chance that you may become an addict. Mm-hmm. I don't want you to become an addict. Instead, use a cannabis product. Have an edible or whatever the case may be, an oil,
yeah.
whatever you want to get rid of your pain mm-hmm. so that you can actually enjoy your life.
Yeah.
I have women come to me all the time saying, Larry, I have my son buy my marijuana for me. I don't want him to go to jail.Right, so why would I want you to either take an opiate product or go to jail? No, I want New Yorkers to be happy.
OK, 尤其是在纽约州呢，目前也有几十万人是得了慢性病的，很痛苦，然后他需要抑制这种痛苦，他有两种办法，要么是用这个大麻之类的那些制品，这就需要这个合法化，让他们不至于担心说因为买这个东西而就入狱了。另外一个选择就是你可以买那个 FDA 批准的那个叫 opiate， 大家如果看新闻也知道，美国目前很多人这个上瘾之后，而且绝大多数都是从中国来的，甚至上瘾之后也就中毒致死了，所以他希望改变这个，当然他支持这个大麻合法化。
And this goes back to what I talked about before.I want you to be able to choose it if you want to. If you don't want to use cannabis products, don't. If you want to use an opioid, don't. I mean, use it if you want to. Use whatever you want to use, it's up to you. I'm not encouraging anything, to be forward. The only drug I use one drug, caffeine, coffee. That's my only drug. That's it, nothing else.
Too normal.
Yes, too normal. So yes, so I'm not going to smoke it, I'm not going to have it, that's not what I do, right? But I want other people who can to use it.
OK， 就是我不会告诉你们去做什么，做什么好。我像我自己，我只喝咖啡，别的东西都不用。但是如果你们想用这个东西 ，OK， 那就你们自己好了。OK，
did I answer your question?
Yeah, next question about the
yes?
gay marriage.
Yeah, OK, good. Now, gay marriage. To be forward with you, I'm a libertarian. What does that mean? That means what you do with your life with two consenting adults is not my concern. It's not my concern. I don't care who you love and how you love them. Not my concern.At all. What my concern is more important, which is a little bit off, but is family court. Family court in New York State is a disaster, and it hurts our kids, it hurts our families badly. So I'd rather fix family court so that when you get divorced, you have a better divorce, you have a better family, and your children have more time with their family than worry about whether two men or two women get married. Just not my concern.
Okay. 就是说他对这个态度是支持的，因为在他看来，成年人之间你们两个人之间自己做了些什么，那是你们自己的事情，他不会介意的。然后像纽约市目前的这个有一个家庭法院，然后也导致了很多的这个麻烦，他希望这个能够改变这种这个家庭法院的这个影响，让人如果哪怕是离婚之后那家庭这个小孩不至于担心和他的父母不能在一起了，然后这个离婚导致双方受太多的这个损失了影响。
What you'll find a common denominator through all of my policies is one important thing. Happy New Yorkers. I want you to be happy because if you're happy, you stay in this state. It's not rocket science. It's common sense. If you're happy,you stay here, which means you grow your family here, your kids get educated here, they work here, You pay your taxes here, right? You start a business here. You retire here, and you spend your pension here. That's what I want to happen. So happy New Yorkers, very high on my priority. And I say that because I'm a business guy. If you're a business guy, you know, if you're in a business, you do many things for your business. But it all comes to one thing, and that is happy customers. If your customers are happy, you will have a better business, right? People will stay, more people come, they tell their friends. That's what I want. As governor, you are all my customers. I want happy customers. Stay in New York State and have your friends come too.
OK, 他说他的这个竞选的所有这个就是让纽约人更开心，更愿意留在这个地方，这个让你的朋友啦什么什么什么之类的，反正都是这样，他不愿意介入更多的这个个人生活之类的。 OK, the last question, 复一下最后一个。
Hi,
我叫复一下，我想就是中国驻
使馆，
雇佣的保安公司的保安多次在中领馆里面外面就是暴力的打人，就是我呢被同一个保安打了三次，打了残废了，就是这个中领馆就是中国政府怎样制止他这种暴力的行为，就是
他有什么办法，他有什么办法，
我只想就是想把这个问题讲一下吧，
就问他一下，
问他有什么办法能制止中国政府就是雇佣保安打人。
Look, she is a resident right now in New York City, but the thing is, when she went to the Chinese consulate in New York City, she was beaten at least 3 times by the security guard.
Really?
Yes, hired by the Chinese consulate for 3 times at least. Yes, and maybe some others also were beaten. So that's her question. Do you have any idea about how to limit the Chinese government to do this kind of?
Okay, I have a question. Why?
Because of. 为什么这么做？共产党为什么这么做？
共产党为什么这样做？为什么打我？
I mean,
she is a peaceful protester, actually.
Oh, she was protesting.
Yeah.
Ah, thank you. Okay, that at least makes sense. Okay, that's why. Okay. Was it on Chinese property or New York State
outside,
property?
Outside
and inside.
No, outside. It's on the street walk. On street walk, street walk, outside.
Wow.
Out of the
no, to be forward, let me be very clear. I don't know why you were protesting, but it doesn't matter to me. I don't really care why you were protesting.
Yeah.
Freedom of speech and freedom of association is in the First Amendment of the United States Constitution.
Yeah.
So I will always support that no matter what. No matter what. Now, if you're on Chinese property, I can't touch that, right? But if you're in New York State property, yes, I can. Of course, I would always want police protection. I would always want you to be protected from something like that. Of course I would.
Yeah.
And no matter what you're protesting, whatever your reason is, right? So of course I'd protect that. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, 他的这个就说得非常清楚。中国领事馆之内呢，那是中国领土，他管不着。但是在中国领事馆之外发生这种情况，不管你是因为什么理由去抗争的，和这个没有关系，他都不在乎。因为美国的法案写得很清楚，第一修正案就是支持人民的这个言论自由和结社自由。所以你只要是去那里抗议，如果在领馆以外的地方受到了中国政府的相关人员的打击，他当然会保护你的。
But I have to go one step further, and as I said before earlier.Whenever there's bad behavior, the number one thing you must do, number one, shine a light on that behavior. That's always number one.
Yeah.
So if that's happening, we should shine a light on it.
Yeah.
And we should show people what's happening. Number one issue. Of course, I'll also protect you.
Mm-hmm.
But no matter what, we must always shine a light on bad behavior.
Yeah. 就是当坏的这种事情发生的时候，第一个我们需要做的就把它给曝光出来，让这个阳光把这个丑恶曝光出来。
就是我就是有一个想法，就是即将开庭嘛，本来10月份开庭的，现在估计要延一段时间。如果开庭的话，就是你能不能就是
别管，
但就是关注，就是能不能支持我，
做一点什么，
做点什么。
Actually, she has a court case against that security guard right now. The case is pending. It's not open yet. So she wants to know if when the hearing is open, do you have any idea to support her?
Oh, I don't know. I'd have to check the. Here's what I promise you. I will look into it. Mm-hmm. I have people on my team right now,
yeah.
and I'm actually videoing this,
mm-hmm.
so I will look into it. But I don't know the details of the case. There's no way I could comment on the case
right.
unless I know details.
Yeah.
Can her send about the lawsuit case to you?
If I'm elected governor, yes. If I'm not elected governor,
after that,
it won't matter.
After that.
Yes.
Actually, you can do lots of things.
Okay.
Whatever when you're governor or not.
Yes, that's true. Good point. Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Very
Thank
good.
You.
Very good. So our event is almost over. It's,
should I give my closing statement?
Yes. Just
okay.
give it. That's it.
Thank you all for coming. I appreciate you coming. Here's what I want you to realize. It's a very simple proposition.
Mm-hmm.
Who else has come here to talk to you? Who else has come here and is trying to go across the entire state and understand what you're thinking and take in any question and any comment with no notes and told you what he honestly feels? The answer would be no one. It's only me. Why do I say that? If you like what Cuomo is doing and you think that this is the state's going well and everything is great, you should vote for him. He will win and you'll be fine and you'll get what you want. No one else has any chance of victory except me. The Republican can't win. He doesn't have enough people behind him. He can only get Republicans and nothing else. He can't get anybody else. The other two small parties, they're too small. I'm the only one who gets Republicans, Democrats, Independents, and those who don't vote in the same room. I'm the only one who gets the young, the middle, and the old in the same room. It's only me.
Whoa, that's good.
They're right, they know. They know.
Yeah.
Yes. So what does that mean? You have two choices. Choice number one, keep the same old thing. Choice number two, vote for me, Larry Sharp, November 6th, this year. If you vote for me, one of two things will happen. One, I'll win. And if I win, I will begin to talk about the things you heard about. I'll try to fix things, make
yeah.
things better.
Yeah.
And if I'm wrong, no worries. You can help me.
Mm-hmm.
I will need you.
Yeah.
I don't have a big party infrastructure. I have you. You will help me. That's why I come here.
Mm-hmm.
But what if I don't win? Great. Then I'll come in second. If you support me, I come in second. And to your point, I can keep talking.
Okay.
If I come in fourth, I can't keep talking. I come in second, I can keep talking.
Louder.
Because the media will say, Larry, how did you come in second? Tell me.
Yeah.
And I can talk about all the things we talked about again and again
yeah.
and again. That's what you need to look at. Remember, it's Larry Sharp. And it's Larry Sharp with an E. And the E stands for electable.
Very nice.
Okay.